question in our consideration, this meditation from the inward journey. In thy presence, we become aware of many divisions within the inner circle of the self. When we enter into communion with thee, we are never sure of the voice that speaks within us. We do not always know which voice is the true voice. Sometimes it is the clear call of the heart, remembering an unfulfilled hunger from other days. Sometimes it is but an echo of some failing impulse to good, which we had pushed aside that a private end may triumph even in the face of the distinct call of truth. Often it is the muttering of needs that do not shape themselves in words because they are one with all the ebb and flow of every passing day. At times, the voice is like a clarion rising above all conflicts and confusions, so uttering the need for courage to stand against some evil, to witness for the good where the cost is high and the penalty great. Sometimes the voice is muted. Sometimes telling us of hopes unrealized and dreams that will not rest until they incarnate themselves in us. All the while we pull back, but they will not let us go. In the midst of all the sounds rising above all the mingled words, there is a strange voice, but not quite a stranger. A man recognizes it. It seems to come from every part of him, but cannot rest itself on any point of sound. He waits, he listens. When all is still, he listens now at a deeper level of silence. In soundless movement, there floats up through all the chambers of his being, encompassing all the tongued cries from many selves, one word, God. And the answer is the same, filling all the living silence before thy face. God, God. We talked about the question, who am I? What is my name? And today I want to follow that with a second question that grows out of the first one. What do I want? What do I want really?